Well, welcome. Welcome, welcome, everyone, to our new Spring Refresh Professional Learning Series for School Counselors. May the 4th be with you. My name is Tanya Bulette, and I'm the Counseling Coordinator for the San Diego County Office of Education. This is our third week, and the theme is College and Career. This afternoon's workshop, I'm very, very excited about, is Increasing College Access for Underrepresented Youth. Just so you know, this workshop will be recorded and it will be posted on the SDCOE School Counselor website. Just give it about 2 to 3 days following today's webinar for it to be posted. So in the chat, we really want to encourage you to use it. When our speakers share something that you liked, we really want you to let them know that. It just increases the engagement and it lets us know that you're there since we can't see your smiling faces. So before sending a message in the chat, please make sure that you click on the blue down arrow button above the message and change it to panelists and attendees. It defaults automatically to panelists. So if you could look at your chat right now and look at that little blue bar, it probably says panelists. If you could change that to panelists and attendees, you're gonna be good to go for the whole webinar. So we're gonna do a quick practice. We're gonna do what's called a waterfall response in the chat, meaning you're gonna type your response in the chat, but don't hit enter until I say go. So in the chat right now, we wanna see who's in the room. So if you could put your name, your position, and the county that you are from, go ahead and put that in the chat, but don't hit enter. Make sure that that little blue tab says panelists and attendees. And in 3, 2, 1, go, hit enter. All right, we're seeing Fresno, Wisconsin, all right. San Diego, Los Angeles, Orange County. Awesome, awesome. All right, we're gonna do one more. We got long, oh, awesome, they're still coming in. San Joaquin County, woo. Okay, so now, I wanna see, cause it's Star Wars day. So I wanna hear who is your favorite Star Wars character? Favorite Star Wars character. So put that in the chat and I'll count it down. So we got 3, 2, 1 and go. Lots of Chewies, got Yoda. How about Grogu behind me? All right, and the responses seem to have a Mandalorian, yeah. Very cool. Okay, you guys got it. You're all doing panelists and attendees. Wonderful. All right, so let's learn a little bit about the workshop. This workshop will give you an opportunity to consolidate your existing college milestone supports and track your college milestone data to help you identify strengths and areas of growth at your school site while learning from other participants. We will also share how the CARPE Network is supporting schools to provide critical information to students about the college process in a distance learning context. Participants will leave this session with possible next steps to share back with their counseling team. So we've got some amazing presenters. Our first one is Edgar Montes. Edgar currently serves as the project co-director of the CARPE College Access Network within the Center for Research on Equity and Innovation at the High Tech High Graduate School of Education. Prior to his current roles, Edgar served as the executive director of a California statewide initiative to scale up a multi-tiered system of support focused on advancing the academic, social, emotional, and behavioral development of the whole child through the Orange County Department of Education. He has also served as Director of State and District Partnerships for the College Board's Western Regional Office, Director of College Counseling at High Tech High Media Arts, and Admission Counselor at the University of San Diego. Edgar earned his Bachelor's of Arts in Political Science and Master of Arts in School Counseling from the University of San Diego. He is currently completing a Doctor of Education in Educational Leadership at the University of Southern California. And our other presenter is Dr. Sofia Tannenhaus. Dr. Tannenhaus is an improvement coach with the CARPE College Access Network at High Tech High's Center for Research on Equity and Innovation. She grew up in South San Diego and attended public schools her entire life. She's motivated by her background as a first-gen Latina. Nearly all of her work is dedicated to improving educational outcomes for historically underrepresented students. Dr. Tannenhaus earned her bachelor's in sociology from UC San Diego and went on to earn her master's and PhD in education from UC Berkeley. She has immersed herself in work to provide better opportunities for students who grew up similar to her. We are so excited to have you both here with us to share your expertise, and I'm going to pass it on to you.
Thank you, Tanya, and it's great to be here with you all. And thank you, Sarette, for everything you're doing as well behind the scenes to help make this workshop happen. So great. Well, we love to start off with our CARPE work to just doing it, what's called a PME. For those of you that haven't done that before, stands for physical, M is for mental, and E is for emotional. And we just want to do a PME check with all of you before we start. So as you can see here, the prompt is here. And if you can just take a moment to put your response in the chat, but I'll go ahead and read it. With everything that is going on in the world, how are you taking care of yourself physically, mentally, and emotionally? So go ahead and take a moment to type in your response because we care about you and your well-being, and we want to make sure that you are taking care of yourself and hear how you're taking care of yourself. So go ahead and put it in the chat, and then once we get a critical mass that has responded, then we will continue on. So great. I see going to the gym, reading the Bible, and writing a book. That's awesome. Great. And then thank you, Zarette, for the reminder there in the chat for how to share with everyone. So I see it working out. Definitely vitamin D, getting outside. And then dedicated time off work. That's important, especially with all of these milestones that we have just gotten through most recently with Decision Day. Edith got a massage. That's great. Meditation, walking. So good. Staying active, eating well. Great. If anyone else wants to type in, and we can surface some of that, but that's great to hear. Okay, going on hikes, awesome. Okay, so thank you to those of you that that shared how you're taking care of yourself. We are going to begin with 3 minutes of journaling. So if you can get something out to write with, whether that's a pen and paper or on your computer. But we're going to give you 3 minutes to answer the following three questions. So the first is, who and what supported your college process, and when did that process start? The second question is, what is one thing you would like to improve at your school site related to college access? And the third is, what is the name of a student you are here for today, and why? So those are your three questions. And if Zarette could be so kind as to also put them in the chat, thank you. Oh, thanks, Edgar. So those are your three questions. I am going to play some music for you as you journal, and then we will do a waterfall chat in a bit. So I will go ahead and play some music while you do some writing. All right. And I'm trying to find a 3 minute song here. This one's close enough. Okay. Thank you. you have about 1 minute left. Mastered the fade out. All right, everyone. So that was 3 minutes. We are going to do another waterfall chat like you did with Tannenhaus. So go ahead and prepare for the waterfall chat by putting in the name of that student that you wrote down you're here for today. So go ahead and type their name and I will count down in momentarily. So we want to see all those first names. All right, 3, 2, 1, go. Awesome, keep them coming. Oh, okay. Thank you. As they continue to trickle in, we like to ground ourselves in our why and who we are here to serve. So you are all doing hard work each and every day to support students. So it's important to just get grounded in why we're all here. All right. Before Edgar takes it away with telling you more about the CARPE Network and we dive into the work we're going to be doing, I just want to also cover some community commitments. We have three here. The first being all teach, all learn. And here, no one knows everything and together we know a lot. So we just want to make sure that we see us together as you know, it's better as a collective than individual. The second, focus on learning, not judging. So we want to encourage you to be curious, listen deeply, and embrace imperfection so that we can learn together. It's totally fine and expected to not leave here with answers, and maybe you leave with more questions than answers. So the process of learning is really beautiful, so we don't need to leave with everything all figured out. And then three, be present and take care of yourself. If you need to have your camera off or you know, take time to do whatever you need to do, hug a kid, stretch, dance, just do you and make sure you take care of yourself so that you can do your best work. So great, those are our commitments. So, and here's our agenda. So we will spend about a half hour on some college milestone consolidation from your school site. So you will take some time to gather all of the things you're doing currently, and we will do some work with you there. After that, we will do some college milestone data tracking also briefly and rating how we're doing there with tracking our milestones. And then we'll end with sharing a little bit about our pathways course that the CARPE Network developed to support students during the pandemic, but actually beyond, because we're gonna continue using that. So we'll talk to you about that. And then we'll close with some feedback. So that's what we got going on today. And we're excited you're here. And Edgar's gonna tell you more about CARPE.
Great, thank you, DJ Sofia. how about you? How about your favorite Star Wars character?
Oh, Yoda.
Yoda,
yeah. What about you?
Yeah, I would say, I'm Luke, yeah. I like a lot of characters, but Yoda as well is probably top on the list as well.
I did go to Costco one time and I saw like these huge Star Wars pillows. I don't know if anyone else saw them, but I got like a baby Yoda for a friend, but it was like this huge pillow anyway.
Star Wars. Thank you for being here today, and we wish we could see all of your faces and be in person when we hopefully one day we will get there. We're excited to present to you today, talk a little bit about our College Access Network, but like we do with most of our participants in our schools that we coach, is we really want to get you to just do an activity and reflect on that activity and hopefully learn from others. As Sofia mentioned, some of the community commitments is to really, you know, all teach, all learn. We really, hopefully you walk away with something, whether there be additional questions or some insights from other schools. We hope that you could walk away with some additional knowledge. This is our College Access Network. And let me go ahead and to the next slide. We have 19 high schools across Southern California currently. This is a Gates-funded network that we are dedicated to really looking at increasing opportunities for underrepresented students. And we have 19 of those high schools spread out across three different counties. We're looking to increase for this coming year to 30 high schools across Southern California. You can see there the impact of the type of students that we are serving. And we know that behind, you know, every student, there is a story and a story that we ask our schools to elevate in this process, because we know that the systems are designed to produce certain results. And it's only as good as this, the design of the systems and the ability to actually work that system. So we do a lot of sort of reflecting on systems change and how do we create a process in which is equitable for all students, including and especially students that are underrepresented, that we know already have some challenges in getting to college and thinking about college options. And so our work with our schools is really to uncover some of those challenges and turn them into opportunities for students and for future graduating classes. We have a very clear aim with the work that we do. And so we remind our network every time we bring them together. This is what really grounds us in the work that we do, to increase the number of students who are Black, Latinx, Indigenous, or from low-income backgrounds who apply, enroll, and ultimately go to colleges that they are most likely to graduate from. Now, we started originally with an aim that was about just college access, about getting more students into college. And although that is, you know, that's still part of our efforts, we want to increase the number of four-year applications and increase the number of students actually choosing to go to college. There was a shift about a year and a half ago where we said, you know, it's great, we want to get more students into college, but it's also about positioning students to be in the best place to graduate in the least amount of time, and hopefully as close to on time as possible. We know nowadays it's getting more challenging to graduate from a four-year institution in 4 years, or complete 2 years at a community college with a transfer and associate's degree in 2 years. So we really shifted the aim, sort of the end vision for our schools, to think about if we really wanted to create some systemic change, how can we rethink the way where our students go, even beyond our high schools and as they enter into college, making sure that they are leaving with the least amount of debt, leaving college with their degree in the least amount of time, and then working backwards, because that has implications for the type of work, the type of college access work to get students into those type of positions. So we have a few things that drive this aim, and you can see here the drivers that we have laid out. This has also evolved over time. We have three main drivers that haven't really changed, which are financial access, college application and enrollment, and then reducing summer amount. So we in California here, we want to increase the number of students applying for the Cal Grant, for the California Dream Act, and of course FAFSA completion as well. We also know that we need to increase the number of four-year institution applications, and also making sure that once students apply, they actually get into those institutions. And so applications and enrollment really go hand in hand. And then once students get accepted, we want them to actually follow through on those decisions that they've made. So reducing the summer melt, reducing the number of students that decide not to go to their declared institutions. This is an area that gets a little bit muddy and sort of gray in many different ways because of the handoff that happens between the high school and the institution where they're going to and seeing, you know, who's really responsible for making sure they transition to their next level. So those are three main drivers for us. We do a lot of work with our network around these three areas. Today, we're going to dive into something that we really have been trying to uncover and then better understand is the college application process, those milestones related to actually getting students to apply and ultimately enroll. But we know that even with these drivers, there are things that support these efforts. So building a sense of belonging in students, we know that there needs to be a sense of confidence and direction when students are actually applying to college. So we sort of infuse that throughout the work that we do. And this work can't be done in silos. We know that counselors can't do this alone. We know that administrators can't do this alone. We know that teachers can't do this alone. So when a team comes together to focus on college access and improving college access, we know that the dynamics and the excellence of the team is critical. So that's part of the work. We're not just focusing on let's get the numbers up, let's get the FAFSA numbers up, or let's get our application numbers up. It's also about how do we strengthen us as a team so that we can tackle college access, but maybe it's, you know, that the following, you know, semester is going to be something else that we're going to tackle. So how do we continue to have that improvement in other areas by having a strong team? All right. One, very specific thing that we constantly go back to, and this is really, you know, fundamental to our improvement work that we do with our network, is to have these routines of looking at data and being able to do something with that data. So we have this, this sort of chart to demonstrate the process that we encourage, that we guide, that we actually, coach our schools and our districts through to really leverage the data that is coming through their system. So when it comes to college access, for example, I'll actually take a FAFSA because that's one area that we've really have done a very routine process of pulling data and looking at data. You know, in California, we have a great state system where we can have schools pool how many students have completed, you know, the Cal Grant and the FAFSA application, pulling that data, segmenting students so that we know, okay, who's left, who has not completed the FAFSA, reviewing that list. Okay, we can segment it if we wanted to do it by student groups, if we wanted to do it by homerooms, if we wanted to do it by counselor assignments, and then making sure that individuals are actually following up on those particular lists. Then planning something. What is it that we're going to do for these particular students? Is it for all students? Is it for some students or is it for a few students? What are those interventions or supports that we're going to provide to these students that we have identified? And then updating the data. Did we have results with what we said we were going to do? Has the list decreased or has it remained the same? And then again, going back to pulling the data, continuing that process again. So we do these cycles as part of a way for teams to look at their learnings, look at what they're doing and seeing if those are having an impact. This also relates back to interventions and supports. You know, what things are working, what things are not working, and what things perhaps, you know, if they're not working or if they are, can we tweak, can we eliminate? And so this really relates back to a lot of the work, the improvement work that we do with our school teams. And so, like I mentioned, one of those areas that we really wanted to better understand, especially this year, is to look at how to better understand the milestones, the processes that students go through to actually create a college list all the way through actually submitting and transitioning to college. So I will turn it back over to Sofia for this.
Thank you, Edgar. And Edgar will actually in a moment be showing you the spreadsheet that we will be working with, but just to kind of tee you up for what you're about to be doing, it will help if you're able to be on your computer right now, because we're all going to be in a Google Sheet based on and making changes basically, or updating it based on what you're doing at your school site. So we will spend 10 minutes. And what you are about to do is you will list out all of your supports for college milestones at your school sites right now. And then we will be providing feedback to others after those 10 minutes, but we will bring you back here first. So I'm gonna ask Edgar if he can show you the spreadsheet so I can just walk you through what you'll be doing, and then we will give you 10 minutes to do this. So at the top, you see the general supports for college milestones section. So there are rows there at the top to indicate everything you do at your school site to support students. And there's an example. So there's a cursor there where a down arrow, you can indicate which indicator it falls under. So whether it is explaining to students like why college, or supporting them in building a balanced list, helping them understand their financial aid options, supporting them with college applications, interpreting their financial aid award letters, and choosing the college that makes sense for them and where they are most likely to be successful, and then the transition to college. So we are going to give you 10 minutes to list out everything. You'll also indicate the audience. So whether that is the learners or the students, parents and guardians, staff or other, the grade level as well. And then you will rate if you think it is a hit or miss, or if it is consistently well implemented, or if it's exemplary, like you guys are doing awesome and other schools should really know about this practice. So that is the top part. That is all you will be doing for 10 minutes. We will all begin by going to this first tab. And because everyone will be entering at the same time, you may wanna pick, another row that's a little further down so that the top ones don't get super affected. But you'll go ahead and put your name and your school site, and we will use this information because it'll correspond to the school tab that you will be using. So if you complete row 4, then you will go to school 4 and then input your information there. And it'll also facilitate how we give and receive feedback after this portion. So go ahead and chat in any questions that you have, because in a moment we will all get started on work, but I wanna make sure that we're clear on what we're doing. So if you have questions, please put them in the chat because I don't believe you can, can you unmute yourself?
Yeah. In the chat, there is the link. Thank you, Zarette, for putting in the link to the College Milestones Consolidation Google Sheet. So hopefully all of you are able to click on that. And as Sofia mentioned, if you could go ahead and just take the time right now to select a row, go ahead and select a number and type in your name and your school, claim your number.
Yes. And go ahead and please, any questions you have for me, go ahead and type them in. Or if you are able to unmute yourself, please do. You can also private chat me if you have a question. But yeah, right now we are just going to be consolidating all of the supports that we provide students, parents, even teachers in supporting their students. So right now is a consolidation, and then we will do some rating and feedback after. So, okay, great. I'm not seeing any questions come through, so I'm gonna go ahead and switch back to DJ mode, and we will set the timer for 10 minutes. So you have 10 minutes to just fill out the top portion of this. Okay, great. So I will put a different song back on, and take care of yourselves, and I look forward to seeing what you all come up with. So, okay, here we go.
Thank you.
have about 4 minutes left. And if you need more time, I'll do a little pulse check to see where everyone's at in 4 minutes. Okay, there is about a minute left. If you need more time, go ahead and either write that in the chat or you can private chat me just so I know how much more time to give. Otherwise, we'll just do one more minute. That was enough time because I didn't get any messages and it looked like people were for the most part done working. So welcome back. Thank you for completing that. We are now going to reflect on our own ecosystem and take a few minutes to jot down, and Edgar will in a moment show you where you will document this, but you will respond to three questions about your own system. So first, what do you notice about your school's college milestone supports? Second, what will you double down on? So these are things that you consider exemplary that you want to continue to do more of. And then third, what might you adapt and how? So those are just some preliminary inklings or ideas for what you might do differently. And you'll get feedback on that later on. But Edgar is about to show you where you will do this. So below where you were working, there's a blue section. And that box right there where he is hovering over, you will type your own reflection there about what you are noticing, what you want to double down on, and what you might want to adapt. So you'll take 2 to 3 minutes to do that, and then we will transition into a feedback portion where we will provide each other with feedback. So go ahead, and if you have questions about where this is, please feel free to ask. Otherwise, I will play another song for you while you do that. All right, thank you. Dancing is optional. Sometimes it helps you work, I think. I don't know. Depends on what kind of learner you are. Okay, about 30 seconds left. Okay, the song faded out by itself. I have really come a long way with my Zoom game. I'm serious, if you all would have seen how I was when I got back from maternity leave and we were in a pandemic and I was just like, oh my gosh, what is happening? I can't do anything. Very proud of myself right now. Okay, so I hope that was enough time for you to reflect on your own ecosystem. In a moment, you will actually be providing feedback to others. So what you're going to do is select, I mean, we can just be kind of, we can wing how we do this depending on how much time you want to take to give each person feedback. I would suggest about 2 other schools and you'll just have to click through, but I don't think we had anyone past what, like 20, Edgar? Yeah. So,
yeah.
So in the first, everyone's within the first 20 tabs for sure. And so you will provide feedback on the following, and that will be below where you did your own feedback, but you will be providing feedback on someone else's tab. So in their spreadsheet, and you will share what you like about their supports that they have, what you wonder, and any ideas that you have. So again, what's really great is the cross-pollination here. So where we can learn from one another, eventually we want to give ideas, steal ideas. So you'll take a few minutes now to about 6 minutes to provide feedback to ideally at least two other school sites, and Edgar is modeling where you will provide that feedback. So you will need to take some time to kind of read through everything they're doing. And then Edgar will leave on the screen the questions you will be answering. So what you like, what you wonder, and any ideas that you have for that person. Okay, so are there any questions before we begin? I don't see anything coming up in the chat. If anything does come up, I will just answer it to the whole group. But we will go ahead and plug along here and go ahead and take about 5 to 6 minutes to provide some feedback. All right, have fun. Should probably turn up the music, huh?
Thank you.
Okay, you have about a minute left.
Welcome back. Thank you all for reflecting on your own unpacking of your college milestones, also giving feedback to each other. Hopefully you were able to find some nuggets of information that would be helpful for you or for your teams back at your school sites or your organizations. We want to now just in the chat, as you reflect on what it is that you do at your site, or what it is that others are doing, what's one idea that emerged from your reflection or your review? So if, let's go ahead and just type that into the chat, whether you had a chance to actually fill one out or whether you were looking at others and what they wrote, what's one idea that emerged from looking at the college milestone, the activities or what folks are doing well? What's one thing, one idea that emerged for you? And go ahead and drop that into the chat just to share with others. Same challenges. Yes. Yeah, absolutely, Christina. Thank you for that. Yeah, having the same challenges, and absolutely, I think that's one of the huge benefits of having a network for other school teams to be able to tackle the same challenges and really reflect on, okay, where can we collectively, you know, do things together, learn from each other, maybe not reinvent the wheel. Absolutely. All right. Freshman Success Week. Yeah, and make it fit to your school. Absolutely, yes. All of these change ideas are, you know, adaptations, modifications, you know, making it really something that might work for your school site. And seeing, you know, one of the things that we had to do this past year, especially with college milestones and FAFSA too, we had to really adapt to a virtual environment for all of our schools. And so we had a very clear change package in terms of FAFSA and a financial aid type of change ideas. We had to have school teams go through the entire process of relooking at all those ideas and how do you change them into a virtual environment. So great, I'm glad you are taking some things away from reviewing or reflecting on your own milestone unpacking. Okay, well, great, keep them coming in the chat. I think it's great for others to hear and to see like sort of, oh, let me go revisit that, or maybe let me ping that person who wrote that. But I do wanna move us along. And this next process is going to be very similar to what we just did with unpacking college milestone, your activities, what it is, you know, you do from when your students enter your sites to when they leave your sites. But we really want to take a close look at the data. Now, we're not going to spend as much time looking at and reflecting on your data because we also know that this may be a growth opportunity for some of your school sites. But we often really refer to data in our improvement work as a way to learn from the data that we're able to obtain. And in some cases, we don't actually know if schools have the data. That was the case with college milestones. We heard from a lot of school sites that they have Naviance or they have SCORE, or maybe they have another system where they have data available, but maybe it's not such great self-reported data, or maybe it's the data is not really showing the things, you know, the improvement or the type of outcomes that we want, especially for our underrepresented students. And so the idea behind leveraging and being able to obtain the data is not so much to bring the hammer over someone and say, hey, you know, we're not doing it right, but better to understand the process of where is it that we as counselors, as, you know, as staff members can intervene, can really support our students, especially looking at the, you know, the process that we take school teams through of segmenting the data, having adults really reach out, having some intervention supports, and then redoing that entire process of reflecting to see if that had an impact. So we do want to spend some time actually having you think through, like, what data systems do we have in place? And if we don't have anything in place, then perhaps this is an opportunity to also learn from each other. So do a very similar process. So you should be used to this already of finding your tab. So as the tab that you filled out for unpacking your college milestones, you're going to go back to that. And in this process, you're actually going to go to the bottom section. So you're going to go to tracking milestone data, and you're going to have three rows to fill out. The first one is, what's the system that you use to track this particular indicator? Who is the primary user of this particular platform? And then how well do you do this? And I'll give you an example. So Naviance, I used to use Naviance when I was a school counselor at a site. I introduced it Naviance to our school. And, I was a primary user. I had to really get a lot of teachers on board, especially at the beginning, senior teachers, because that was the primary way of getting teachers to write letters of recommendation. And so, but I will say, you know, it took some time to get a routine of having students consistently go back to Naviance to update their accounts at different milestones, whether it was, why college actually was, we actually started more, I would probably say for Naviance, for us, it was more building that balanced list. I really wanted to see of the students I had, where are they in building their college list so that when I meet with them, I can actually see, okay, I see which colleges you have on your list. You're telling me what it is that you want to, you know, get out of your college experience. I can see your academic profile and other things that you want out of, you know, college. And then I can better guide you to maybe think about some other colleges or maybe some colleges that are on your list that maybe, you know, are not the reach or the range or the really sure schools that should be on your list. So again, you know, you may have different systems. We know that some of the schools that we have in our network, they have started off with Google Sheets, just being able to track this information via Google Sheets. And sometimes it's just one person that owns it. And in some cases, it's done very well. In other cases, maybe not as well. So we're going to go and give you 5 minutes to fill in this section. So just be the tracking milestone data section. The three rows, and then after that, we're going to do some self-reflection and then feedback, just like we did with the unpacking of college milestones. All right, so DJ Sofia, could you find us a 5-minute jam?
Yes, I can.
All right, so we'll give you 5 minutes to fill in the section of your milestone data.
Thank you.
You have about a minute left.
Hopefully that gave you some time to list out a few areas that you are, how you're tracking your data and who's using it and how well you're doing that. Let me stop my timer as well because it's just about to go up. All right, so the next slide, we're gonna have you do some reflection and then we'll do some feedback of others' tabs. So we'll spend a few minutes doing some reflection on what you notice about your school's College Milestone data, what will you double down on, and what might you adapt and how. So just spend, we'll give folks maybe, Sofia, what do you think? Maybe 2 minutes for this one?
Yeah.
2 minutes, just self-reflection on your data. What are you noticing from your, you filling in those cells? So we'll give you 2 minutes to do that.
Okay, that was about a minute and a half, but if people need more time, we can give them more time. What, another 30 seconds?
Yeah, another 30 seconds. So I will say that the data piece is certainly one of the most challenging areas. And so if you have if you didn't write much in your reflection or if there's a lot of empty holes, you are not alone in this area. And we'll talk a little bit more. Sofia will be able to talk more about sort of our own response of as a network, what we were able to do to really support our schools in this effort. So no worries if you don't have much in terms of the reflections. I just skimmed through some of the tabs, but we do want to just, if you can give some feedback to some of the schools that did actually complete those tabs. If you just take about, maybe we'll do another 2 minutes, Sofia, of just feedback in terms of their systems that they have in place, who's owning it, how well they're doing it. Just anything that you like, you wonder, or any ideas. go ahead and just click through some of those tabs that have things filled out, and then we'll be back in a couple minutes. Well, hopefully you were able to look through some of the systems that folks are using to track their milestones, the owners of that, and also just how well they're doing it. I will say, you know, this process of uncovering, you know, what we did with you in just the course of, you know, this session today is sort of all day workshops that we do with our teams. We really try to have teams unpack their process, because if we really want to get serious about increasing those opportunities for underrepresented students, we need to understand their journey. And so part of that journey mapping is to really understand the system in which they, you know, they experience and they receive these supports. And so the first process that you did was really to just uncover, okay, what are we doing? And are we doing it well? You know, who are we targeting? Mostly our seniors? Do we do any type of attention for our freshmen, our sophomores, or juniors at our sites? And so, you know, just understanding the system first, the process is part of like getting to the next piece, which is really sort of trying to then influence that process and those, you know, the students that are going through that process of how they can really think through their opportunities. And then the data piece. The data piece was, you know, we had a very concrete process of looking at FAFSA improvement, because as I mentioned, this, you know, the state here in California has a great way of providing to schools all their how students are progressing in completing the FAFSA and a Cal grant, and schools can pull that data every week. Not quite the same. And as I'm looking at your tabs as well, you know, that still remains a challenge for many schools in terms of really understanding where are students in that college application pipeline. And I will say it is, you know, having the data as a coach that coaches school sites, if I know that a school has, you know, a group of 20 students that said, I want to go to, you know, UCLA, I want to apply to UCLA, I can have the school look at that list at the beginning of the year. And then I can see in like early November, mid-November, or late November, did those students actually follow through on that college, you know, college application? And so not having data at the beginning point, at the midpoint, at the end point to see, did they, you know, are they actually following through? Are the efforts that I am doing or the school is doing, are they actually having an effect to help influence a student to complete that UCLA application, what they said they were going to do? And if they got in, did they actually, you know, enroll? And so the entire process is you know, to improve it needs some data to be able to leverage that. So Sofia is going to talk a little bit about our efforts to really better understand the journey in looking at the data that is coming back, but also how do we add value to students that are many times first in their family, coming from low-income backgrounds, to be able to know the process of going to college. So I'll turn it over to Sofia.
Thank you, Edgar. And yeah, as Edgar was saying, you all know as counselors that it's already difficult to, get in touch with some students when you are at school, and the pandemic posed additional challenges. At the same time, CARPE saw this as an opportunity to provide students with support in a different way. And so we came up with Pathways, which is an online course that I will tell you a little bit about. So this was our change idea for how to adapt college advising in a virtual context. And so I think that all of you will appreciate this. This is like our dedicated counselor slide. So this is probably, we have this little gift for what counselors might feel like at this point in the week. So what schools usually do in terms of college applications and college support is counselors will go to each senior class, whether it's econ or English, and present information about the college application process. And counselors will then ask senior teachers to administer surveys to collect milestone completion data, or they collect this data through one-on-one check-ins with students. So we know that's what it typically looks like. And so what we ended up identifying as key challenges for 2020 and 2021 were these three questions. So first, how can we provide critical information to students about the college process in a distance learning context? Second, how can we maximize the time counselors spend directly supporting students in navigating the college process? So how can we get students the information that they need in a tier one fashion so that we can support students with tier two and tier three support? That's where counselors can spend most of their time. And then three, how can we get real-time data about where students are in the college application process, as Edgar was saying, so that we can provide support to those who need it most? So really this was about maximizing counselor time and getting students the information that they needed. So what we ended up doing is thinking, okay, we need to work smarter in this pandemic. And so Pathways is a 6 lesson asynchronous online course. And they started by completing it over the course of senior year. This spring, we've actually changed that, and juniors are completing the first 3 episodes, or 2.5. I mean, episode 2 has a couple sections, but they start actually the spring of their junior year. Each lesson is 20 to 30 minutes, and it provides information about how to complete a specific milestone, whether it's interpreting their financial aid, filling out FAFSA, college applications. So students answer questions that feed into a database, and counselors have access to that data, so they know exactly who needs help and with what, and then they can provide targeted support.
And Sofia, if I can just interject here, we know that some of our school sites still use Naviance. Some of them are transitioning from using Naviance to using SCORE. Others use CCGI in California. We have a great system that helps track some of these milestones with community college, CSU, and UC applications. And even though our schools still use these systems and districts in many cases pay for them, we also know that we wanted to get a bit more granular in the type of information that we wanted school teams to have in order to do something to intervene at certain points to make sure that students follow through on those plans that they had, especially again, looking at students that perhaps are in those student groups, are equity groups that we really wanted to focus on.
Yes. And so thank you, Edgar, for adding that on. And so we defined success, and I know I have only a few minutes left, so I will just say that students were completing personalized versions of the episodes and that they found it informative, but the modules were integrated into their core classes. And then the CARPE team, so the teams that participate in our network, had essential information that that were disseminated to students, so then counselors could focus more energy on direct support. And then for our network, we were able to track progress for the college milestones in real time and really make data-informed decisions and follow through. And so going on to the next slide, this is just kind of a preview of the Pathways website. If you're interested in learning more, I will ask Zarette to put that into the chat and you can check out the different episodes and what it's all about. I will just share, we do have student voice embedded in the episodes, and these are all students who identify as students of color and are usually first-gen students as well. So we're going to play two very short clips, and this is just so you can get a flavor for what is embedded in the episodes.
Just say to take the chance and apply to schools you might not even think about or necessarily be considering going to, because it might open on opportunity for you that you didn't have before. I know I definitely closed myself off to a lot of opportunities just because I didn't think it would be for me or I didn't think I'd get it. But just trying just to see if it works, I think.
I would just say, like, I wish I had heard, like, you belong there. Like, this is, like, this space, like, wasn't created for you by any means, so it's going to be hard. Like, it was created for kids that are, like, that come from, like, college-going families forever and, like, kids that are, like, rich. So just know that, like, this space wasn't created for you, but you still belong there. And it's going to be difficult, but, like, by all means, it's a space for like you too, and it's gonna like completely transform your life. Even by just like your sophomore year, it's already like transformed how I see a lot of things. So I would just say like really utilize your resources because you're gonna need it. It's gonna be like a very difficult process, like emotionally as well as like academically. So just, I don't know, make sure you like talk to as many people as you can to just get as many resources as you can, because you're not as well resourced as a lot of the kids that are applying. So I don't know, I would just say, yeah, like you belong there. Just, I feel like getting that reassurance like early on.
The feedback we have received about Pathways, students have found these testimonials particularly helpful for them. The near peer effect, as we know, is extremely important for students, especially first gen students, to hear going into college. So the next slide is an overview of Pathways. All I'll say about this is the left slide is what Pathways covers, and the right side is what teams, the information that they receive. So they get segmented lists there so that they know which students to follow up with. And so you can see that. You'll have that for your future reference if you're interested. But yeah, the Pathways has been our change idea for how to provide as high of quality of counseling to as many students as possible during a pandemic. If you want to learn more about the work that we're doing and you have Instagram, or you can, you know, also share this with students, we do post resources, important reminders about the college application process. We also have this FAFSA six steps resource. So, you know, you can just keep that in handy for next year. But yeah, lots of goodness on there if you are interested. But and if you want to learn more about Pathways or even, you know, apply to CARPE, Edgar will actually share. We're at a very exciting time right now in the year for CARPE, but he'll share more in a minute or so.
Thanks, Sophia. Yeah, we have about a minute left. Just as I talk a little bit more about just ways to join our network, if that's something that's of interest to your school, just one takeaway from today, a takeaway that would increase the likelihood of a student that you had in mind at the beginning of going to college. What's something that you take away from today's session that would increase the likelihood of that student that you had in mind going to college? So as you think about that, put that into the chat. I'm gonna just close off. We'll also put the link to a quick three question survey, very short, probably takes you 3 minutes or less to complete that survey. But we are always about looking at data and finding ways that we can improve. And so we have a quick survey that we'll just put out to all of you as well. And the last thing that I'll mention is just as Sofia said, we are actively looking for other schools to join our network. We have 2 years left in our grant efforts. And so we are looking to increase to about 11 high schools across Southern California. So if you know of any great candidates, please have them apply. It's the website's also, the link is also on our website, but we'll toss it into the chat as well. So with that, thank you all for sticking around and being part of this. I'll toss it over to Tanya.
All right, thank you guys so much. So many great resources. And if you haven't heard of the CARPE Network or all the great things that they're doing, it's definitely worth the time to check out their information, to email Edgar or Sofia if you have any questions. They do so many great things. And their workshops are really in depth to help you really discover what kinds of tools and things you might need to add to your campus to support your students. So take the time and really investigate that if that's something you're interested in. We do have a survey as well that Zaret has put into the chat. So if you could please take time to answer those questions and give us some feedback, as well as some positive inspiration for our guest speakers for taking time out today to present this information to you. And with that, we thank you again for being here today. And we're gonna head on out with our theme of Star Wars. And so we're gonna take that away. Here we go. Thank you.